Hi friends, it's me, Miss Chacon. We are back. Today is Monday. I hope you all had a great weekend and I hope you all had a very, very fun Friday. Before we start, I just want to remind you to please turn in your homework. We have so many friends who are turning in your homework and I'm so proud of all of you. You're doing such a great job, okay? All right, and also, if you ever want to look at our plans for the week, you can go to Class Dojo. We have it posted on our class story, and it'll take you to something that looks like this. So it looks like this, and it has our plans for the week. So today is our math test, and we're going to be reading a book called Believe Me, Goldilocks Rocks. So that's going to be fun. And we have a lot of fun stuff for today and this whole week. So be sure to keep looking at the plans on Class Dojo because it's kind of like a checklist. It helps you check off to see what you've done and what you haven't done. So you can just go check, check, check. Okay? And we have it in English and in, let me pull up my Spanish slide. And there we go. And we have it in Spanish too. So it's for your parents so they can read it too. All right, friends? Okay, so let's get out of here. And just remember for our test today, please don't worry about getting a perfect score or having to do it exactly the way to get 100%. Please don't worry about that. Remember to use your own brain power to try your best and forget the rest. So please don't worry about turning in a perfect test to Mr. Cohn. Please don't worry about that, friends. The reason we're doing this test is not so I can see a perfect score. This test is just to show me how much you've learned. So please don't ever think that, oh my gosh, I have to get a perfect score. I have to do everything right. You absolutely do not. I want to know what you know. I want to know what's inside your brain because you have an awesome brain. So I want to know what's going on in there. So that's why you just have to try your best and use your own brain power. Okay, friends? All right, so let's get started. So this one is our chapter test on graphs. Now we're going to be looking at picture graphs, bar graphs, tally charts, and all of that. And we've learned about all of this. So please don't think, oh no, I don't know what this is. You know what it is, trust me, friends. And if you forgot what this chart looks like, you can always go back and look at other videos and get a little bit of extra help with that, okay? All right, so let's read this. So it says, read the questions and circle the correct answer. How many elephants are there? So here we have animals in the zoo. Here are the elephants, here are the lions, and here are the monkeys. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna count how many elephants there are over here, okay? You are not gonna be counting over here. You're not going to be counting this elephant plus this elephant plus this elephant plus this elephant. You are only counting the elephants over here, okay? So you're going to count the elephants and circle which answer makes sense to you, okay? Then we have, so after you're done with this, we're going to look at our tally chart. Now, what you're going to do first is this tally chart is asking people, what is your favorite fruit? Is your favorite fruit a banana, apple, or is your favorite fruit a pear? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna count the tally marks and write the total right here. Count the tally marks, write the total right here, and count the tally marks, write the total right here, okay? Then after you finish our tally chart here, you're gonna answer this, okay? How many votes did the banana get? So after you've put all the totals here, you're gonna look at the banana and say, how many votes did the banana get? And you're gonna circle either 4, 5, or 6, okay? You can do 4, 5, or 6. So you're going to count how many votes the banana got and see if the banana got 4 votes, 5 votes, or 6 votes, okay? Then on number 3, you're going to say, which fruit has the most votes? Now they're asking about fruit. They are not asking about numbers, so you're not going to be answering 3 or 4. You're not answering that. You're answering with the fruit. So, is the fruit with the most votes or the highest votes going to be an apple, a banana, or a pear? So, look at banana's votes, look at apple's votes, and look at pear's votes, okay? And see which fruit has the most votes and circle your answer. So, will it be apple, banana, or pear? Okay? Now, let's go to the next one. Favorite ways to go. So some people voted and they said This is a picture graph, okay? And we're looking at what is your favorite ways to go, your favorite ways to travel? Airplane, car, or bus? Okay, so you're gonna look at this chart right here. And how many people like to travel by airplane? So you're gonna count these airplanes and answer 4, 5, or 6, okay? Then we have, so after you do this one, you're doing objects in a drawer. So this is a bar graph. So this is a picture graph and this is a bar graph. We read our bar graphs differently. So are there, how many pencils are there? How much glue is there? And how many scissors are there, okay? And you can see that in pencils, there are 4 pencils in the drawer. Glue, there's two glue bottles in the drawer. And scissors, there's 1 pair of scissors in the drawer. Now the question is asking, how many more pencils are there than glue? There are 4 pencils and 2 glue bottles. How many more means that you are going to subtract? I can't tell you what you're going to subtract. I don't know the answer. You have to find out the answer. All I can tell you is that you're going to be using the number of pencils and the number of glue, and you're going to subtract. Then, once you find your answer, circle it here. Is the answer 2? Is the answer 3? Or is the answer 4? Okay, my friends? All right, so that's the end of our test. If you need any help, please just ask. And remember that this is just a small test, so don't worry if you maybe don't know the answer or anything like that. That is completely okay. This is how we learn. Mistakes are how we learn, okay, friends? All right, so that's the end of our lesson. I hope you all had a great weekend. You're gonna do awesome on this test. And that is it. Stay safe and stay well, friends. Bye.